Welcome back, friends. And I say that with all sincerity. You are my friends if you are followers of Jesus Christ. I welcome you to the Morning Mindset. If you are new to the Morning Mindset, I welcome you as well. Thank you so much for joining me each morning. And I encourage you to make this a morning habit of getting your mind aligned with the truth of God. And I pray that you will be blessed by what is shared here in the Morning Mindset through the Word of God. If you'd like to know more about the Morning Mindset, you can look in the description right there on your podcast player or app, or you can go to careygreen.com, careygreen.com/MM, and find out all you need to know about the Morning Mindset. Let's look at Psalm chapter 95. I can tell already as I look at this passage that this is going to take a few sessions, maybe even three or four, because there is so much in here that is of powerful importance to us, because this is a song of praise. Now, we understand praise and worship, those kinds of terminology, if we spend any time in the church, you know, and we tend to think of it as the music that goes on in a worship service. But my friends, let me encourage you to think differently about that. Everything that goes on in a Sunday morning service or a Saturday night service or whenever it goes on is praise and worship. Everything from the giving of the tithes and offerings to the sermon to the prayers to the announcements, it's all praise and it's all worship, because it all should be done in the spirit of reflecting back to God gratitude and thanksgiving for what He is doing and what He has done. And that's kind of a little rabbit trail, but I think it pertains to what we're about to read, because Psalm 95 gives commands to sing, to give praise to God. And these are things that we find somewhat foreign at times, because hardships are going on in our life, or difficulties, or things we don't understand. And in those times, it can be very hard to praise, to be actually grateful and thankful to God. But I want to begin reading, and let's stop at a point or two and just unpack what we're reading. It says, "Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. Let us come into His presence with thanksgiving. Let us make a joyful noise to Him with songs of praise. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In His hand are the depths of the earth. The heights of the mountains are His also. The sea is His, for He made it, and His hands formed the dry land." Now let's stop right there and think about this for a moment. We have a writer here who is imploring us to join him in singing, making joyful sounds of thanksgiving to God because of who God is and what He's done. Well, what are some of those things? Well, first of all, He is the rock of our salvation. If we are to be saved from our own sin and from the perils that sin brings into our lives, it is going to be because of Him. Amen? It's God the Father who sent His Son Jesus to die for us. He tells us, let's sing songs of praise because He is great. He's a great King above all gods. So any gods you've heard about in mythology, they are nothing compared to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, our great God that we serve. He is the true God. It says also, in His hand are the depths of the earth. So everything down below the surface of the earth that we kind of know about but don't know about, it's so mysterious, it is God's. He holds it. He controls it. It says the heights of the mountains are His also. The sea is His, for He made it. Have you watched these planet Earth documentary sort of things that show all the different creatures under the sea? Oh my goodness. What amazing diversity there is down there that we don't even know a fraction of. You see, the psalmist is pointing out to us that God understands, and not only understands, but is in control of and has created all these great things that we see day to day. And because of that fact, He is worthy of our praise. So look at your day today, and in spite of the difficulties, consider God is in the midst of it and over it and in control of it. And He therefore is worthy of your praise today.